Last time we are going to study the second major stage of meiosis, that is meiosis 2. I told you meiosis 2 is exactly same like mitosis. So it is also called as mitotic division. Same process happened, so it will be revision for you for mitosis, and as well as you will understand meiosis 2. But in between meiosis 1 and meiosis 2, for a time being, cell take rest, and that resting period is called as interkinesis. So you need to remember this term. What is interkinesis? Interkinesis means between two divisions, and here it is taking place between meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Now, interkinesis is of short phase compared to interphase. So student, let's go back and see this thing. So this is a meiosis. Reductional division is meiosis 1. How it happened, I taught you. Now what happened to the haploid daughter cell? They undergo mitosis. This is how each daughter cell formed from meiosis 1 forms total 4 daughter cells at the end of meiosis. So now we are going to study the second stage. What happened after meiosis 1? As it is meiosis 2, all terms will be called as karyokinesis 2, cytokinesis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, and telophase 2, etc. Right? Now this starts with karyokinesis 2. Again, I am repeating, what is karyokinesis? It's a division of nucleus. Division of nucleus takes place in four stages: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Now, all the stages will be termed as prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, and telophase 2. Now we'll study each phase in detail. Let's begin with prophase 2. Now, as I told, it is same like mitosis, so I will draw the diagram, you observe it carefully and recollect what had happened in mitosis prophase. So, in the diagram you can see what has happened in prophase. The haploid cells of chromosome which was present after meiosis 1 now undergoing equational division. In case of early prophase, you can see nuclear membrane, nucleolus is intact. The only thing which happened is chromatin fiber is getting condensed to form chromosome. In case of early prophase, you can see the chromosomes are thin and longer, and they are showing only two chromatids. What is chromatids? Arms of chromosome. And in case of late prophase, you can see the chromosome has become short and thick, and they are showing presence of four chromatids. Speaking about nuclear membrane and nucleolus, in case of late prophase, it is getting disappeared. Also, the centrion get started dividing in prophase, early prophase, but in case of late prophase, it is started getting moved towards the polar region. Last, you have to remember about the nucleolus, which is getting disappeared. So here we completed with prophase 2. The next stage which we are going to study, student, is metaphase 2. I will draw the diagram, observe it carefully, and just relate it what is taught to you in mitosis metaphase. So student, like mitosis, over here also, central got positioned itself at the pole region and chromosome got itself arranged at the equatorial plane. In between central and chromosome, you can see there is presence of spindle fibers. Now, this spindle fibers will attach to the chromosome only at centromere. You can see it clearly in the diagram, it is not getting attached here and there, it is exactly getting attached to the center of chromosome, that is called as centromere. And here, the important characteristics of metaphase is we can see spindle fiber clearly in metaphase. One more thing you have to remember, spindle fiber formation starts in prophase, late prophase, but it can be clearly seen only in metaphase. The next phase which you are going to study compared to the mitosis is anaphase, and over here, as it is meiosis 2, we will call it as anaphase 2. Now observe the diagram and try to relate it with the anaphase of mitosis. Spindle fibers are made up of contractile protein. That is why in anaphase you can see when the spindle fibers are getting contracted, automatically the daughter chromosome or sister chromatids are moving towards the respective pole. In metaphase you have seen that chromosome is arranged at the equatorial plane. So what exactly happened in case of anaphase? In case of anaphase, the centromere first got divided, and that resulted into separating of sister chromatids, which formed daughter chromosome. I hope you remember sister chromatids and non-sister chromatids. Again, I will repeat with a diagram over here. What is called as sister chromatid and what is called as non-sister chromatid? Assume this is one chromosome and this is another chromosome. The arms of the chromosome I am labeling as A, B, C and D. Of another chromosome E, F, G and H. Now listen to my statement carefully, then you will understand which one is called as sister chromatids and which one are called as non-sister chromatids. And at the end, I'll ask you one question you need to answer. Now, first, speaking about sister chromatids. AND is sister chromatid. Observe it carefully. AND is a sister chromatid. CND is a sister chromatid. In short, the chromatids present on the same chromosome are sister chromatids. Now speaking about non-sister chromatids. BNE is non-sister chromatid. BNG is a non-sister chromatid. HNA is a non-sister chromatid. In short, the chromatids of different chromosome is called as non-sister chromatids. Now you tell me, student, crossing over which took place in packeting of prophase 1 of meiosis 1. Is it taking place between sister chromatids or non-sister chromatids? Correct. It is taking place in non-sister chromatids because this part of the chromosome and this part of the chromosome was getting crossed over. So it is clear that crossing over takes place in non-sister chromatids. After completing anaphase, I hope you know what is the next phase. Right? Definitely you know the next phase is telophase 2. So let's see how telophase 2 looks like. So in this diagram, if you observe carefully, it is looking exactly the same like the telophase of mitosis process. Over here you can see nuclear membrane and nucleolus reappear. Secondly, the chromosome had converted into chromatid fiber. But remember, student, over here the number of chromosome is only 23 in case of human cell. That means only one set of chromosome is present over here. And by this we completed karyokinesis 2. Thank you very much, student.